earth floated then below. The chariot paused a moment there. The spirit then descended. The restless coursers pawed the ungenial soil, snuffed the gross air, and then, their errand done, unfurled their pinions to the winds of heaven. The body and the soul united then. A gentle start convulsed Ianthe's frame. Her veiny eyelids quietly unclosed. Moveless a while, the dark blue orbs remained. She looked around in wonder and beheld Henry, who kneeled in silence by her couch, watching her sleep with looks of speechless love, and the bright beaming stars that through the casement shone.